Remember that 1Password you used for everything? Well, it's time to ditch that risky habit and embrace 1Password. Like, not the single password anymore, but the password manager where you can have as many logins as you want all in one place. But you get the point. Let's do a proper 1Password review and tutorial and see if it is the one for you. Before we get started, please hit that subscribe button and help me reach my subscriber goal of 10K. All right, first, why is 1Password suddenly so popular? Well, it kind of never stopped being popular. It was created by two buddies back in 2005, and they just wanted an easy and secure way to manage their accounts. They couldn't find one they fancied, and so they made their own, making one of the best password manager picks. What kept 1Password a solid name in the industry is the security that it provides. Everything in your 1Password account is always end-to-end encrypted. The data is kept safe by the golden standard AES 256 encryption, and 1Password uses this keyboard head smash looking thingamabob for key derivation. In human language, it means it makes it harder for someone to guess your logins, so your details will stay safe and sound. Another big reason 1Password is so popular is that it's very affordable. There's an individual plan, but the family one has the best price to value ratio if you can find 5 people to share this password manager with. Of course, there are a team and business plans too. What's really kind of cool is that 1Password gives you a 14-day free trial, and it's not merely a suggestion, they force it on you. But hey, this way you can test the app out on basically any device you want, and there's also a browser extension that works really well. If you do want to try it, I put a link in the description that will automatically apply a coupon code to get you the best current price, or you can just scan this QR code. But in case you're curious to know more, let's do a quick 1Password tutorial from setup to capabilities and features. The setup itself will take a few steps, but it's relatively quick. Once you've picked a plan, they're going to ask you to add the extension to your browser, which is going to auto-save and auto-fill your passwords when you're browsing. Then create your account and follow the directions to verify your email. And be sure to create a strong account password, but make it memorable, as this is the one login you'll have to remember to access your vault. You'll also need to add a payment option and generate a secret key, which is what they use as an additional security layer when you want to log in from a different device. But you don't need to memorize it. Just click here to get your emergency kit, which will also include account recovery info and instructions, so store it somewhere safe. Now, the installation part of this 1Password tutorial is actually super simple. For Mac or mobile, you can just get it from the App Store, while for Windows or Linux, the 1Password website has a download list under the Resource tab. The installation itself is standard, just a bunch of agree and continue buttons, and you are all set. Once you have the app and complete the 1Password login, I recommend visiting the settings menu first. There is a bunch of generic stuff in here, like appearance, but our main focus right now is the security section. Here you can decide whether you want to set up things like Touch ID to make your life easier, assuming that your device supports that. Then I suggest enabling the auto lock function for extra safety, just in case you ever leave your device unprotected. But if you really want to protect your account as much as possible, you can also enable multi-factor authentication, which will be an extra confirmation step as you log in. You'll have to set the 1Password MFA up through their website in the More Actions section under your profile, and then install a separate authenticator app on your mobile device. Now, if we go back to the 1Password app and its settings in the Privacy tab, check all the boxes under the Watchtower feature. This tool constantly checks for any leaks or breaches related to your saved accounts, and it uses data from the Have I Been Pwned database. The Watchtower also flags any passwords that are considered weak or easily guessable, and alerts you of any accounts that support two-factor authentication but don't have it enabled yet. It seems a bit extra, but in light of how many breaches are happening these days, taking a few minutes to upgrade your passwords is very much worth it in the long run. Well, now that we've set up all the security stuff, let me show you the main features. First up, import your existing passwords. Let's be real, you probably have a bunch saved in your browser already. Just head to File and then Import, and you can bring in passwords from Chrome, Firefox, or any password manager app. Now, if you're creating a new login, you can use the 1Password password generator. You can make a passphrase or get the regular symbol vomit looking thing that would be impossible to remember without a password manager. That said, 1Password isn't just about password. You've got categories for everything. Credit cards, secure notes, documents, even your passport or driver's license scans. It's all gonna be encrypted and kept safe. Now, let's talk about vaults. You get a private vault for your personal stuff, and you can create new ones like work, family, or super secret pizza recipes. You know, whatever works for you. If you're on a family plan, you can even share specific vaults, either by adding the recipient's name or email address. This functionality is actually why 1Password is so often dubbed as the best password manager for family. Not many others let you share entire vaults. Of course, you can share individual items too. Just select it and then click share, and you'll get a link to send to the others. And you can also choose when it will expire. Now, let's talk about the 1Password extension, because this, at least to me, is what makes a password manager the most convenient. That mainly comes from the Autofill feature. When you visit a website, the extension icon will show you any saved logins for that site. Just click on it and it fills everything in automatically. No more copy-pasting. That said, that's still totally a possibility, but keep in mind that your copied login will only stay in the clipboard for 90 seconds. Now, if you're creating a new account, 1Password should automatically offer to generate a strong password and save it right away. Plus, it syncs instantly with apps on all devices. So whatever you save on your phone will show up on your PC and vice versa. Now, everything I mentioned so far is pretty standard stuff for a password manager app. However, 1Password has some unique features as well, like travel mode, which temporarily removes selected vaults from your devices before crossing the border. Just mark the vault you want to keep as safe for travel, and then turn on travel mode on the 1Password website. There's also a feature called privacy cards, which is great to try if you're worried about online shopping security. This tool lets you generate unique virtual card numbers for different websites. You can set spending limits, create one-time use cards, or lock a card to a specific merchant. So if a store ever gets hacked, your real card details are safe. And there you have it. That's 1Password in a nutshell. It's really easy to use, yet upholds high security standards and even has a couple of completely unique features while remaining very affordable. I hope this 1Password review helped you out. If you do think that 1Password is the one for you, grab a discount through the link in the description. If not, check out my other password manager recommendations by subscribing to the channel. Cheers.